So let's move on to the next tip to help you improve your vocabulary. Okay. So Yash, just go for a short recap. Okay. So right, I'll quickly do that. So there are three tips that I gave right now. So the first one was to get a dictionary, specially made for idioms. So you need to start memorizing certain idioms. Okay. You can also get a lot of resources available on the internet if you can't find a dictionary for idiom. So go for those PDFs and start memorizing 5 or 10 idioms every day. Try to incorporate them in your daily day-to-day life conversations. Okay. The second tip was to read from various resources, like from newspapers to magazines. And the third tip was to find out these synonyms of commonly used words, the ones that I was discussing right now. Okay. Right, let's move on to the fourth tip, which is where I would ask you to use more collocations and start learning what are these collocations. I'm pretty sure you all use collocations in your daily lives, but you would not know. Some people might not know what are collocations. So I'll give you an example. Now collocations, let me first explain what are these. I'm pretty sure it's going to be a jargon for some of you. So collocations are words that are used together, like a group of words or maybe two words which are used together. When you separate them, these two words have different meanings altogether. For example, social media. Now, if I say social and I say media separately, these two things have different meanings. But when I club them together, I say it like I use a lot of social media, right? So I'm using a collocation, social media. Similarly, social as a word can be used with another word as well, which becomes another collocation. Social gathering, social service, right? There are many things that you can come up with. There are other collocations as well. For example, take a break. You can also say, I'm going to take a nap, right? So take a nap is another collocation. Now we use these collocations, but when you know that the examiner is particularly going to give you good marks if you use more collocations and you use them appropriately, why not start memorizing them? Okay. So for this also, you can actually refer to the PDFs available on the net. But there are certain good books available in the market. One is from Oxford. There's this book, Collocation. You can purchase that and you can start memorizing some collocations. And it's not just going to be helpful for you for your IELTS exam. In your personal and your professional life, it is going to have a lot of impact on your conversational skills, right? So you can maybe purchase this. This is going to be like a good investment for all of you. So start memorizing some collocations as well. This was my fourth tip for all of you. Coming on to the next tip. I want you to start watching some videos, particularly go onto these platforms, Netflix and maybe Amazon Prime, and pick up these interesting web series. I personally watch Young Sheldon. I've learned a lot of things from this web series, not just how to be good at having conversations with people. I've had a lot of new words. I picked up really good words from this web series. So when I watch any series, what I do, I don't do it every time, but yes, sometimes I do keep a pencil and a paper with me and I make notes, right? So when I'm watching it for the purpose of learning something, I keep a pencil and a paper. But If I'm binge watching, I don't do anything like keeping a pen and paper handy. I don't do that. But if I'm learning something, I will definitely keep a pencil and a paper. And I write down some new words that the person, the characters use. Or, I sometimes also turn on the subtitles. It's difficult to catch their accent sometimes. So I turn on the subtitles and I make notes. This is what I would recommend you to do as well. This is like a nice activity and you'll enjoy doing it. Trust me, you will be able to speak like them because not just one skill is involved. You're watching something, you're making notes. So all your motor skills are involved here, right? So please make sure you do this activity. This is also going to help you improve your vocabulary. Okay. Mithali wants me to repeat tip four, right? So tip four was to use co-locations, Mithali. What I want you to do is you can go and search on the net, what are co-locations? I gave you certain, you know, gave you a couple of examples. You can you can start memorizing some co-locations, and you can purchase a book which is from the Oxford. I'll type the name of the book, the exact book, in the chat box like later, okay? Otherwise, you can find some resources on this thing, on the internet. They will help you out with some co-locations. These are some free resources, and I'm pretty sure they're going to be helpful for you, okay? All right, and the fifth tip was to basically do what? Do watch these web series. There's this Young Sheldon, I would recommend this. Then you can also watch The Big Bang Theory. That's also a nice series. You'll get to learn some interesting vocab from there as well. All right. Okay. Any doubts, anyone till now? Anything that you would like to ask before we move to the next part? Okay. What about the rest of you? All good to go? Let's move to the next. Yeah, I'll type all these things in the comment section. You can later watch these, go through the comment section, okay? All right. Let's move to the next tip, which is very interesting. So what I would want you to do is, I want you to watch a couple of videos that have been uploaded on YouTube, right? This is another way of improving your vocabulary. Now, when you watch these videos on YouTube, now, what kind of videos are you supposed to watch? See, if you're preparing specifically for IELTS, you want to clear your IELTS exam, you registered for the test, and you want to prepare for that test, right? So go through some videos where you can watch other people giving a mock test, okay? Or you can also watch these videos where a person is taking the test, the examiner is giving, the examiner is taking the test, and the person is responding to the questions, right? So there are a lot of mock tests available, speaking mock tests available on YouTube. We also have a dedicated channel, our YouTube channel, where you are live right now. You can watch a lot of videos that we have uploaded. So you'll get to know how the test is conducted, what kind of questions are asked, and how are we supposed to respond to these questions? What kind of vocabulary will fetch me good marks if I'm taking this test, right? Idioms are particularly important. Using collocations is important, right? Having fluency and pronouncing each and every word, having clarity in your speech is important. So how do we get to know all these things? By watching videos. So you can watch a lot of videos on our YouTube channel. We've uploaded quite a lot of videos. You can go through those videos one by one whenever you get time. You don't have to do everything in one day. Pick up one video, do an analysis. Okay, how was the speaker talking? Like, what words did he or she use, right? And are there any words that I can use in my speaking test? So I'm going to make a note of those things. All right, this is another way of improving your vocabulary. Right?